Hi, there are many cases our customers ask us, how can I repeat an entire block on every page? So in our case, we have an order that we want to process, and the order actually has multiple products, as you can see here. For every product, we want to print out the details on a different page, and we want to show the details of these products. For instance, our third product has a different address, an alternative delivery shipping address. So we want to show this address because we are in this order. Okay, how to go about that? Instead of printing the page three times or running it three times, or we will just want to do it generically, depending on the number of fields and number of records that we have. So, first thing we do, we actually cut out everything from our table. We're gonna add another table. And so we don't want any margins in this table. So no padding at the side. And we actually want this table to be invisible. So no borders. Okay, now our table is here. It's totally invisible, but it's a placeholder for PDF Butler to know that it's going to have to repeat this table. I'm going to call it table products. Okay. And now, as you can see, I just pasted the entire item, the entire block into this page. Okay. So we have that. That sounds great. We're going to tell the system now to repeat this table. And on top of that, we're going to tell the system to repeat this table and make sure the next table is always in a separate page. So there is always a page break between every page that it's going to print. Let's take a look how to do that. First of all, we're going to select data from Salesforce. So we go to our data sources. There are videos enough on how to create data sources, so I'm going to spare you that one. I made a data source on the order object, and I did it via the Suckle Builder. So as you can see here, it's the order object. I can select any extra field that I want. I've added, of course, a filter to it, a where class to filter on the ID, and I have a bunch of fields that I want to use. Okay. Next up, I want to select all of the products that are linked to this order. Okay, not a problem. Create a second data source. I called it order lines. And as you can see, I just selected a bunch of fields via the Suckle Builder on the order lines linked to this order. Next, I created a .config. And in this .config, I of course uploaded my document. So this is the document I'm using. It has this table and all of my data inside. Linked my data sources to it. So the two I have already created. And then I created a config type of type table and linked it to my order lines. So it means that PDF Butler will now repeat this entire table for every order line. So for all three products we have linked here. Okay, now it's still not doing that on a different page. So we have an extra configuration item, page break. Add a page break in between means that between every table it will create, it will clone for every record. It's gonna leave a page break in front of the next table. Of course, the merge field to identify this table, that's this one here. I do not want to see afterwards, so I'm just going to say merge field, remove the merge field afterwards. Now, this is already linking the table, so next up is just creating a bunch of config types as childs, of course, of this table, and to fill in all of the data that's required. So let's take a look. I've already filled in the customer name. And I did something special to show the shipping street or the alternative shipping street. I showed you that we had a product that had an alternative shipping street, a shipping address, So I did a smart thing, and I put the shipping address actually in a separate table. Again, no border, no padding, no margins. So the table is invisible, and I've created two rows. One row for the shipping streets of the order, and another row for the alternative shipping address. Then I've went back to PDF Butter, and I created as a child of our table a table row. And what I've told the table row, I've added a criteria to only show this row when there is no shipping address. So the shipping address is empty. Pretty easy. And then of course I fill in all of the shipping details. But yeah, it's a demo, so I'm not gonna fill in all of the details. I'll leave it up to you. Then I did the same thing for the alternative shipping address, but of course it's the other way around now, so it has to show when the shipping address is not empty. That's clear. And I've already also added the alternative shipping address. In this case it's a text area, so it's a text area that I'm filling in. Okay, cool. This is a bunch of fields. We didn't add the product name yet, so let's add the product name as well. It's a child of our table, product name, use the parent data source because we want to get it from our order lines. The product name, okay, goes quickly. Then the quantity that I want to do, okay, add again, quantity, parent data source, quantity, let's do no formatting, there are other demos on formatting, save to server. Everything checks out fine. Our fields are now filled. We have told to repeat the table. Let's take a look. So I'm expecting to see three pages, a page for every order product. Click the button, data is prepared. The document is already there. It's been done in real time, amazingly fast as always. And as you can see here, we have now our perfect overview. This is our first page, our first item. It shows that it has to go to the industry and it's the 10 kilowatts diesel. Then we have the next one, it's 1000 kilowatts. It's also going to the normal address, the shipping address on our order. And last but not least, it's our 2000 kilowatt gasoline engine. And this is of course showing the alternative address that was linked to that product. So it seems that it's actually doing what I'm expecting it to do. So yeah, we have three fields here, three pages here. Per page I have my order. It did nicely a page break between every order, so it's nicely put on every time on a new page. Yeah, what else can I do? I can just keep on filling data, of course. So let's fill in the delivery date as a child of our table. Okay, the delivery date. And the delivery date is part of the order. So let's take the effective date, a short formatting. Okay, and do we have the total price? Sure, why not? Okay, total price. Yeah. Of course, we want currency formatting. Okay, save to server. Let's close this one, test it again. So it takes the new template, and as you can see, filled in the price, filled in the date, filled in the install description. Oh, I've made a mistake here. The install description looks very much like the date. So I probably did an oopsie, and let's correct this. Install description here. I'm just gonna remove it, create it again, because it's that easy to create it. Let's take the install description, table, add a new one, install description. It's of course the parent data source because it comes from other lines. Then the description, and okay, this one, save to server. Let's do this again, because it's easy and fast. Okay, and to be installed in the lobby, to be installed in the big production hall, and no install description. So looks like we have a perfect order for our customers to give out to our technical team for the installation, everything we need. Okay, thanks for watching.